Welcome to the second round. This hand is very good. Now that we have our street fight in the deck, I can also play Death Shadow. Like last match, where just to burn them out, I'm not sure if it was correct or not. I'm not really a fan of street fight, but we'll see. Okay, Land Ponder is a good start, I like. Because it means that we can be the aggressor and not have to react to my opponent's threats. It might be Storm or... Yeah, it might be Storm. Did not shuffle, and yeah, let's just probe my opponent before fetching, since I want to know if... And they are indeed Storm. But next turn can already put a lot of tokens into play, which is kind of scary for me. Which is very scary. I guess I have to bluff something here. Or am I maybe just looking for something? Looking for like a Thoughtseize. Now I have to bluff something, like a Stifle. If I bluff Stifle, I can counter the Storm trigger. And maybe my opponent doesn't go for it. Yeah, they can go 10 tokens, which I can never beat. Looks like they're going for it. Which is reasonable. Do we have any answer? No, right? Yeah, no. Yep, easy game here. When I have Null Rod, or when I have maybe Cage. I don't really like Fire Covenant, even if it deals with the tokens there. So this is the 8 cards that I want to bring in. Because I want to cut our Dismember, push, Bolt. Bolt, reanimate. I think calling his command as well. And everything else is kind of fine. Can frame something. Like a Tombstalker might be too slow. Yeah, let's just go with this. Game 2, we're on the play against Storm. And we have a pretty good hand with a turn 2 M to Turek. Don't really care of cycling right now. Just gonna play Death Threat for now. Like, even if I have Thoughtseize, I think it's better to lead with Death Threat. Because the odds of my opponent comboing off on turn 1 are very, very low. And instead, double spelling on turn 2, it's way more important. Alright, Swamp Go means that I can't even play Brainstorm in response. Your Force of Food exactly what I wanted. I'm gonna just Street Rage right away. I guess I want to play Ponder here. Ponder into Turek, it's where I wanna be. Alright. I think I wanna do like this. No. I'm gonna cast Probe. Draw the Delver so that I have a blue pitch. And I have just 2 less life. And know my opponent's hand most likely. And then with a Badland, I'm gonna get rid of 2 random cards from my opponent's hand. Rite of Flame, not a card that you used to see a lot. Still a Polluted Delta to get the Watery Grave. Let's see what we got out of that 7 card hand. We got Rite of Flame and Lionside Diamond. Opponent is now left with a bunch of bad cards. Next turn I can even play Delver. Maybe. Alright. Yeah. Ponder's gonna fix the top to flip my Delver. But I don't find a blue card. So, can I play Tombstalker this turn? 5, yeah, I can. Okay. So, I guess I would just play Tombstalker. I don't really care about Thoughtseize here. Shuffle library, nope. Yeah, I have to fetch. Go get my sixth card in the graveyard. I probably would have Watery Grave. No, I guess not. I'm just gonna play. Just gonna take an underground sea in case my opponent goes off with Empty the Warrens, though it's gonna be pretty unlikely. Yeah. Just gonna do Tombstalker for. Gonna do Tombstalker and attack for 1. Still holding force. Now the clock is real. Need to pressure the combo deck to really win it. To really win against them. It's not only about Force of Will and Discus Veil. You need to have a clock. That's why I'm not in love with four color deck. Four color midrange deck that just has Baleful Strix and Snapcast Image to pressure them. It looks like my opponent is casting something here, otherwise they would never fetch in front of a Deathrite Shaman. Maybe it's just a bunch of tokens. I think I'm gonna let the Chromox resolve. See if they imprint something. And even if they play like 6 tokens, it's not gonna be a huge deal since we have Deathrite and Tombstalker. Even Deathrite I think can be fine. Yeah, Deathrite is so good. It's even a 1-2 that blocks 1-1. Opponent is pitching Burning Wish, okay. Now it's gonna go just for 4 tokens here. Okay, I'm living with Now, I'm gonna play this since it's most likely that my opponent will just go land into Umbara right now. It's called Infinite Infernal Tutor. Then I force that. Opponent really wants to empty their hand. Not sure if it's correct to attack there. They want to attack. Okay. Losing 1 goblin for 3 damage. It's fine. Alright, Thoughtseize. I'm gonna play it since I still have 6 mana for force. And maybe I was supposed to play. Delver last turn. Now it's not really a problem. I'm just gonna leave that on top so that I can either eat with Deathrite and play Force. It's still gonna be lethal since I have Tombstalker that my opponent can't really deal with. Okay, that's just how with to be combo decks, you know, Discus Spell, counters, and pressure. It was a pretty easy game. I don't think I want to change anything, so let's just go game 2. Game 3, sorry. Alright, this hand looks pretty good. I'm not sure now. I mean, we'll see how the game goes, but maybe being on the draw, I really can't afford to play Delver on turn 1. Steal the 1-2 punch, Thoughtseize time to Turek. Can give us enough time to deploy a threat on turn 3. Alright, now it's important to see if my opponent shuffles or not. Because if they don't, you know, the Thoughtseize decision might get a little bit trickier. It doesn't want to get this back-to-back 5-0 ruined, but we really want a 5-0, so, you know, it's conflicts here. Conflicts right here. Thoughtseize him, and we see Cabotherapy and Duress. What to take here? So my opponent will just discard our Hamtet Turek next turn. Can't discard Empty Turek and Ponder because he has only one blue up, so I'm definitely not gonna discard a Disco Spell. I'm gonna probably go for Burning Wish since it's the most payoff card. Opponent with a very slow hand, which I really like. It's gonna give us time to draw our sideboard card. Is not shuffling again, but now he has to shuffle, so he has drawn two cards from that hand. Oh, he chose Delver. Wow, so he's willing to get Heim to Turek. That's interesting. Ooh, the rod I like. Gonna get Watery Grave. Then I have to track my opponent. I got Endurance and Infernal Tutor. That's a very good hit. Very good hit. My opponent only with two cards in his hand. Cabotherapy is gonna name that Shadow, I guess. Ponder, okay. Okay, so zero cards in his end. I can cast that Shadow next turn as a 1-1, but we don't have any more Watery Grave. Or just Shockland in general. Alright, it's gonna get rid of my Null Rod. But he has zero cards in his hand and doesn't know the top of his deck. I guess I can't play Death Shadow. Because I really want to hold the Red Elemental Blast. Ooh, this is something good. I just shuffle away those two Death Shadows. They're pretty bad at the moment. I mean, I can still draw one, but I don't think I want to. Alright, I'll get a Badland. And we'll see. Ooh, Delver. That's just perfect. Don't the Thoughtseize my opponent? Yeah, I guess so. It's kind of weird. Last turn, my opponent played a land, and now they didn't. So I was not expecting them having a land there. Gonna get rid of a couple of therapies. See if we flip. We don't. Okay. Just one. Maybe I'm supposed to just exile a pay of cards like Infernal Tutor or Burning Wish. Instead of a couple of therapy, mostly considering that my opponent doesn't know we have a Red Elemental Blast in my hand. Okay, still not flipping. But that's not a big deal. So my opponent's gonna go down to 8, and then next turn, if I flip, they die. Let's see if we flip. Yes. Alright, should be. This game should be over. Let's just attack, and it's gonna be game. Yeah, I don't know what does it mean with GG ruined. You just lose sometimes. It's not that I've done something bad. All right, 2-0. Let's be back for third round.